diamonds on. Fleet, bitch, ain't talking about heat. Put it on.
Hey y'all, so today we're going to be doing a tutorial on how to get a sleek ponytail. So we're going to start off by getting that part all the way crispy. I believe firmly in crispy parts, so we're going to put some edge control on there and we're going to follow it up with a rat tail comb. Okay, and what kind of ponytail would it be if she didn't have those edges laid? So we're gonna go ahead and lay them edges, girl. And as you can see, she's experiencing some damage on her edges, but by the end of this video, you are going to see they are going to be 100% covered up. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with my Revlon flat iron. I love this flat iron when it comes to straightening out hair, because when I tell you it's a beast, like, I have a flat iron for everything, but straightening hair, definitely like number one. So I'm gonna go ahead and get her hair straight, because when it comes to natural hair, you wanna make sure that your curls is pressed out, because you can't really achieve that sleek pony with all those curls. And she got some really curly hair, okay? And I got this flat iron from my local Walmart. It was only $20. And I bought it as like a temporary thing while I was moving. And I was not expecting this performance, but it was definitely worth those $20. Okay, so now you can see that I skipped like the back portion, because that's pretty standard for doing a ponytail. I just used jam and I started pulling it together, brushing it, and getting it into a ponytail. Now when you're doing a swoop, it's a little bit different, because this is the part I wanted to show you, because a lot of people aren't familiar with how to do that. So what I did was I used some edge control that I found at the beauty supply store. I go and I try like different edge controls, because there's some that's like too greasy. Other ones that don't have really, you know, a good hold. I tried Murray's and I tried She's Bomb. They weren't really what I expected, but when I tried Edge Effect, oh my god, it exceeded my my thoughts of what an edge control could be. Okay, like when I tell you, it gets it in place. It's not greasy and it has like a tight hold, like you put some spritz on it. It's amazing. So I'm using that and I'm parting it section by section and putting that on the roots and combing it out. So you want to take your time, because you don't want no splits in your swoop. So you're going to have to swoop, swerve, whatever you got to do to, you know, get it right. And you want to use a fine tooth comb as well, and follow it up with a brush if you have to. If you find that your comb is too wide, you want to just use a brush so that you can close up those gaps. So now what I'm doing is I'm sectioning the front portion, and I'm going to have it come on her forehead a little bit. So you're going to take your edge control, like I said before, and put it on your roots, and you're going to swirl it, okay? So you want to keep doing that and put your edge control comb swirl, edge control comb swirl, okay? So it's going to be a repetitive process, but it's going to be so sleek when you are done, okay? Okay, so another thing that I do is I take the edge of my comb to basically line up the front of that swoop and get a perfect circle, so that even if your brush isn't really working and closing up those gaps, you can always use the front of your comb, like I just said, and close up those gaps, because like I said before, it's not going to be cute if you have a whole bunch of splits in your swoop.
Tell me cause that's my bitch. I invested too much and dying ain't really worth it. From hair dudes, house calls.
And those last two pieces that you seen, I just parted off. I am not taking it all the way to the front. I am taking it midway through the bang and filling up the bang, making it thicker, because you don't want to push it too far to the front where it looks bulky, okay? So we're going to go ahead and slick it just enough so you still have that part, but you are gathering it so that it's not going straight back.
It don't seem you had the time, but I'm so happy that you're mine. I'm so thankful that you're mine.
I got something that I gotta tell you.
What you trying to tell me, babe?
I feel the same way that you do. Babe, I'm in love.
Yeah, babe, you know I love you too, huh?
Okay, so now at this point, I'm putting like gem on my comb and I'm slicking it back with the rest of the hair so that it blends in and it's not too hard, because I didn't want it to be two different textures from the edge control and the gem. Okay, so now I'm taking a brush and I'm cleaning up everything. And I'm going to go back and make the side a little bit thicker on her ponytail. And I'm going to add some hair to the back of her ponytail as well. And you will see the finished product in a few seconds. And I appreciate you so much for watching my video. If you made it this far, I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did making it. So if you haven't already, subscribe and share, okay? And don't forget to leave a comment as well. Bye.